To consider the structural side of structure and function, we're going to consider an organizational scheme that really applies to all of biology. We're really only going to look at the first half of that as it applies to an individual organism. And we'll see that it's actually a scheme that we can use in organizing a course like this. Structure or form is a more basic way to refer to anatomy. And while we'll be looking at the structures of many different parts of the human body throughout this course, I want to instead think about structure in this introduction as a way to organize the information about the human body. To consider a word anatomy based on its etymology, we can break it down into two major parts, ana and tome, and the y at the end is an ending that makes it a noun. Ana is a prefix from the Greek that means in this sense up, which makes sense when we consider combining it with the root tome, which means to cut. So anatomy is the act of cutting up or apart. Really, it's sort of a Greek word that means dissection. And if you look at the Latin dissection, dis basically means apart and sect means to cut. So dissection and anatomy are the same word, one in Greek and one in Latin. And when we think about anatomy, what we're actually looking at is the structures that we can see when we take the organism apart by dissection. In biology, there's a hierarchy of structural organization which goes from the finest levels down to individual atoms all the way up to the most broad levels, looking at the entire environment that living organisms are found within. In this course, we're going to look at really just the bottom half of this organizational hierarchy up to the individual organism level. We won't really consider the interactions between organisms within populations or at the biome level or that sort of thing. We're just going to keep it to the levels within the organism as we consider what's going on. The most basic level of this hierarchy is the chemical level, which includes atoms and how they bond together to make molecules. And those molecules can be very simple, like the water molecule, or they can become much more complex, up to macromolecules like DNA. The first section of the book starts with looking at the biochemistry or the chemical level of organization as part of the foundation for learning the human organism. The next level of organization is the cellular level, which is where those macromolecules come together, often forming small structures within the cell called organelles. Cells will combine together along with macromolecules that may be secreted by those cells to have a common function, and we call that a tissue. So the next level of organization is the tissue level. Multiple tissues can come together to form an organ. Organs can also be composed of membranes, which are more than one tissue coming together to have a specific purpose. Multiple organs that are connected together and work towards a particular function make up the organ system, which is the next level of organization. Which brings us to the organismal level, or the entire human being. Now, in this course, what we're going to do actually is to start by looking at the chemical level, the cellular level, and the tissue level organization within the first unit, building the foundation of what's going on. And then, after we finish with tissues, we'll start moving into organ systems, and we'll consider how tissues work together to make up organs and how particular organs make up a system, such as the skin or the integumentary system. At the end of that, we have the whole organism, which is at the end of ANP 1 and 2. However, it's not that at the end of ANP 2, we're going to say, ta-da, the puzzle's all finished. Instead, as we're going through the organ systems and considering their individual organs, we're also going to be considering how those organ systems interact together, like when the muscles and the nervous system work together to move our bodies, as well as what it means for the whole organism itself. Consider this question. When you feel that you've reached an answer, hit the next button to go into the next slide, which will reveal the correct answer. Membranes are combinations of tissues, usually an epithelial and a connective tissue, that work together, such as the lining of your respiratory or digestive tracts, which puts it between the tissue level of organization and the organ level of organization. Within the chemical level of organization, we see molecules and macromolecules, also as these sort of in-between points.